Now to our top story, an explosive new document claiming Congressman Duncan Hunter used campaign money to fund extramarital affairs. And the congressman will go to trial on felony campaign fraud charges in September.
Our attendance reporter John Horn has been pouring through those documents, and John, the prosecutors say these affairs, they did not come lightly.
Oh no, we're talking $1,000 dinners and $300 dinners and $1,000 vacations, excuse me. The filing comes just hours after Congressman Hunter's legal team tried to get the case dismissed, calling it politically motivated. But one read through this and it paints a picture of love affairs with no legitimate campaign purpose paid by the congressman's most loyal supporters. New documents say Congressman Duncan Hunter's eyes wandered almost as soon as he took office in 2009. And he had hundreds of thousands of dollars in campaign contributions to, quote, satisfy his desire for intimacy. His personal bank account, meanwhile, deep into the red. The campaign-funded affairs allegedly began in April 2009 when Hunter met a lobbyist the filing calls Individual 14, the congressman eventually moving in with her at her home in the Washington, D.C. area. In January 2010, Hunter allegedly spent more than $1,000 for the two to travel to the Hyatt in Lake Tahoe. Later, back in D.C., the filing says the two spent the night together in a room Hunter's wife Margaret reserved at the Capitol Hill Hotel. Margaret's travel plans delayed one night. That relationship ended in April 2012. But later that year, Hunter reportedly found a new mistress at the Republican National Convention in Tampa. Individual 15 worked for a fellow representative. Prosecutors say Hunter began sleeping at her place nightly, documenting trips using Uber ride records. Then in January 2015, they say Hunter began a relationship with one of his own office workers. He took her, identified in documents only as Individual 16, and his high school-aged relative out for pizza. That tab, $352 donated dollars. In October 2015, Hunter began seeing Individual 17, another lobbyist who had organized events for him in the past. On October 27th, the two allegedly went back to her home where they engaged in, quote, intimate personal activities unrelated to Hunter's congressional campaign. The documents chronicle one last relationship with a lobbyist in September 2016, prosecutors also using Uber receipts paid for by campaign funds to show trips back to his office as early as 3 a.m. Congressman Hunter did speak to some reporters in D.C. today, again repeating the charges are politically motivated. Prosecutors say, however, that this document shows they are not. Now remember, Margaret Hunter changed her plea to guilty earlier this month, agreeing to testify against her husband.
Mm. Okay, so John, prosecutors have obviously known about this for a while. Why release this now?
Well, there's a couple of things. In the last 24 hours, Congressman Hunter has filed a motion to get the case dismissed, saying it's politically motivated. Obviously, this shows it is not. And prosecutors also concerned about public thoughts on this influencing a jury that maybe they think it is politically motivated. But of course, when you have this, it changes everything.
Hard to claim that. And now his wife has agreed to testify against him, only going to make it worse.
Yeah, and everything's going to happen in September. She's going to be sentenced then, and his trial's going to be going on then. So we'll have a lot of stories on this in
September.
Eyes
of the nation will be on San Diego.
You bet.
All right, thank you, John.